In this video, we'll look at three different approaches your children can use to construct their baby bear's chair. Using paper and tape, straws and pipe cleaners, or recyclable objects. The option you choose will depend upon the ability of the children and how much time you have. This method builds upon pupils' previous knowledge and allows them to develop their techniques, adding three new possibilities to their paper construction repertoire. They can roll different diameter tubes to create stiffer components for their chair. By using thinner cylindrical objects such as pencils, wrapping the paper loosely around them and securing with tape. Demonstrate how they could link their tubes at right angles by flattening the last 2 centimetres of the tubes and taping them together. Don't be stingy with the tape. The more they use, the less likely their strictures will fall apart. The final paper and tape option is to create a class superstructure, as explained in the Lesson 2 video, by making several tubes and combining them using tape or an elastic band. This option will create a strong and stable structure, and the children can explore varying the height of the tubes to create back and armrests for their chair. To mix it up a bit, the children could use different coloured paper and decorate the outside of the paper before it's rolled, allowing them to personalise their designs more. Using straws and pipe cleaners is another good way to increase the variety of materials and construction techniques that the pupils can experiment with. Simply place the pipe cleaners inside the straws. When joining one straw to another, make sure that the pipe cleaner is sticking out of the end like this, so that you can slot the other straw over the end of the pipe cleaner. Work with the bends in the straws to create simple angles. The straws can also easily be chopped down to size using scissors. A third option is for the children to create their structures out of recyclable materials, such as kitchen roll tubes, cereal boxes, and milk containers. They can trim down what will be the base of the chair out of a cardboard box, then create slits in their cylinders like this, and simply slot the base into place. They could also explore balancing card on top of the cylinders. Just encourage them to be creative with the materials. It's more important to experiment with stability rather than create a perfect chair. Having seen your demonstrations of both the finished chair and the individual parts it's comprised of, the children should be able to create their own chair structures. However, what we're aiming for here is for them to be creative about the approach to their design rather than directly replicating yours. In this topic, the children have learnt about the different ways materials can be used to make a stable structure and how some basic structures are built.